you, Julianne, take this man to be your lawful husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and health, until death do you part?
I do.
Mitch, repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
You have exchanged rings, you have exchanged vows, and so by the power vested in me by this great state, before God and these witnesses, I now pronounce you man and wife.
First of all, thank you to Julianne's mother, Kate, and her husband, Charlie, for throwing this great party. And I'd like to thank my dad, who couldn't be here today. He always said that if I were to tie the knot with a woman that I hadn't been dating for at least a year, he'd throw me in the cellar. And I think, in this case, he would make a very big exception. And I'd like to thank my truck for not working most of the time and making me take the bus that night that I met Julianne. And finally, I'd like to thank my wife for locking up my heart and throwing away the key. Cheers.
Cheers. Oh, are you sure you want to do this?
Yes, Mother, I'm sure.
Okay, so be careful. I want you to come back safe and sound for my birthday party.
I will see you in 2 weeks.
All right, darling.
Bye. Get me the fuck out of here.
Yes, ma'am.
Seven. I'm by your side, baby, it's heaven. I promise you, you're never alone anymore. All right, won't let you go. I can't get enough, girl. You can't escape. L-O-V-E.
It was a hunting trip with my dad about a year ago.
And there's no running water?
Nope.
No television?
Nope.
No electricity, internet access, telephone?
Yeah, we can stay longer if you want to.
How did I let you talk me into this place?
Oh, Mitch, take me on an adventure. I gotta get away from all this country club BS.
Shut up! I do not sound like that.
Mitch, I love your adventurous spirit.
All right, fine. 2 weeks is more than enough for me, though.
Or maybe three. We could do three.
2 weeks.
But I thought you... There was a
Mitch,
glimmer in your eye.
When
I said three, you perked up. There it is.
All aboard.
Are you sure that thing's safe?
This boat? Come on. She's a tank. Come on, Jules. I would never let anything happen to you. You know that. My dad used to bring us to a place like this when we were kids. No matter where we moved, he'd always bring us right back to the woods. My brothers and me would spend hours pretending we were on a chain gang. Countless hours of fun.
I get lost in a second.
That was the fun part.
I gotta call my mom. She's probably having a nervous breakdown by now.
All right. What's the matter, babe?
You said you checked to see if there was service here, right?
Yeah, I mean, the guy said it was work.
It's not working.
You wanna go back?
No, you said it was an adventure, right?
Right. But won't your mom kind of freak out?
Yep. What are those?
Well, that's an old tradition. Hunters use hash marks to count out the nights that they've been here, how many animals they got, stuff like that.
We were here, got some deer back next year. SR and JR, 82. Poetic. I could fix this place up a bit.
You don't like them here?
No, I love it. It's rustic. Keep up the tradition.
Very nice. I'm gonna grab the stuff out of the truck before it gets dark, okay?
Mitch, I hurt myself.
Baby, okay?
No. I stubbed my toe.
Is that better?
No.
How about now? No? Not good enough?
Spend the rest of my life with you. My clockwork.
Good morning, sleepyhead.
Hi.
You know, today is our 2-day anniversary. How do you want to celebrate?
Let's order a room service.
Ooh, sounds good. I'll call the front desk. Hey, babe, is that leaking down there?
Yep. Trying to fix the roof or just make more holes in it?
That's pretty funny, huh?
Tell me a campfire story.
I don't know, babe. All the campfire stories I know are a little scary.
Come on, I'm tougher than you think.
What do you think about the name Jack?
Jack?
Yeah. Yeah, or Hugh, maybe. Little Huey.
Come on, you know we talked about this. I want to someday, just not now.
I know, but I was just thinking about someday.
I don't know, I guess it's just like, this is the first time I've ever even been on my own. Don't you think I should at least finish classes?
Yeah. My little Picasso. I hope our kids get your creative genes.
Mitch!
I do. We got something really special, babe. Really.
Just think, in the parallel universe, I'm still at school making my mom proud. Learning how to spay little kittens. Plus, I'd still be with Anthony.
Mr. Trust Fund.
Hey, Mr. Jealous. I meant it as a compliment.
Well, he could certainly never take you to a place like this.
And that's why you owe me the full camping experience. So now, please, tell me a campfire story.
Okay. How about the one where a couple goes on their honeymoon? Way out in the woods. And they sit and roast marshmallows, get terrorized by the local maniac.
Ooh, I don't like that story. Tell me the story about the prince who rescues his damsel in distress, and they live happily ever after.
Why don't you come in?
The water looks cold.
Looks cold. You know what? I think it's time for you to get wet.
No, Mitch, I want
come
the
here.
Water.
You can run, but you can't hide.
Get wet, Mitch. I'm serious.
The water's not
Mitch,
that bad.
Mitch, I don't want to go in. Mitch, please. I really don't want to go in the water, Mitch. Mitch, please.
Oh, what's the matter?
I put on my makeup and it's gonna get all messed up.
Okay, well, why don't I just sit you on the raft? Don't worry, honey. You won't get wet. I anchored the raft to a rock, babe. It won't float away, I promise. Just relax.
Don't you ever leave me like that! Damn you, Mitch!
What are you mad at me for? I didn't know the raft was gonna sink.
I can't swim.
You never learned how to swim?
I'm afraid of the water.
Julianne, why would you let me bring you here?
Because I thought that maybe if I was with you that I would get over it. I didn't think that you were just gonna leave me like that.
Well, why didn't you just tell me?
I don't know. I'm sorry, okay?
It's okay. I'm sorry. I didn't know. Sorry, babe. I don't mean to.
Mitch.
Yeah, baby.
Would you still love me if I dyed my hair black?
Yes, I would.
What if I shaved my head?
Yes, I would still love you, but I like your hair a lot.
What if I got fat?
Baby, are you thinking about changing your hair? Is that what this is about? I like it the way it is, but if you want to change it, that's fine.
Forget it.
Bottle it up and take it with me wherever I went. Then I can open it up and have you right next to me. No matter where you are. Grip it here. I'm gonna take the line and hold it up. Now with this hand, flip over the bail. Now when you gotta cast it out, let go with your index finger. Not bad. Not bad at all. Now reel it in. Quick, the lure will sink. Here you go.
I noticed that you have a safe box inside.
Yeah.
Why do you have it?
Just for security.
Security from who? We're in the middle of nowhere.
You never know, Jules.
What's in it?
Car keys. Stuff like that. It's not a big deal. Jules, okay? It's nothing.
I didn't say it was a big deal. I was just asking.
No, well, stop asking, okay? I didn't bother you about all that makeup that you trucked in here. I mean, Jesus, who the hell do you have to look good for out here anyway?
Hey, Jules, will you come out here for a second? I want to show you something.
You made me an easel.
So you can work. You know? Do your painting. I'm sorry, Julianne. So you still love me?
I was thinking maybe we could take a trip into town today, you know, buy a newspaper, eat at a restaurant, maybe call my family.
I thought you wanted an adventure.
I do, but, I mean, don't you want to see what's going on in the world, you know? Anything?
Sounds pretty good.
Anyway, my mom's probably freaking out, so I should really call her.
That's over an hour away, Julianne.
I know, but what's an hour out here? I mean, time practically stands still.
There we go. That ought to do it.
And what happens to the poor little animal?
You know, most of the time the smaller animals don't even survive the impact. Julianne? Fine, but you gotta be more careful out here.
Ow, baby, you're hurting my wrist. Don't you think we should start thinking about heading back soon?
What?
Well, it's been 10 days, and I was just thinking...
We said we'd be here 2 weeks.
I know. And it's been wonderful. It's just that, you know, I'm really excited about going home and starting our lives together.
Start our lives together? Julianne, this is our lives together.
It's just that I've never gone more than a couple of days without talking to my mom.
It's not like she's going anywhere. I mean, look around you, Julianne. Everything here. This is us. This is our lives together. This is where we need to start, where it's just you and me.
I want to go home, Mitch. I get this whole nature and earth and woods thing. I do. But I want to go home. Let's go.
No.
What do you mean, no?
I mean, no. Julianne, no.
Are you not listening to me? I said I want to go home.
This is our honeymoon. We can't just quit before it's over.
So I figure if we leave now, we could probably be home around midnight. And I don't really think we're gonna hit the...
Julianne, we're not leaving!
What is your problem?
What is my problem? When we both decide that it's time to leave, that is when we will leave. You're in a bad mood right now, and that's fine. It's gonna pass. But don't fuck up our whole honeymoon because you miss your goddamn mother.
Fuck you! You were the one who said the cell phone would work up here!
I told you already that the fucking guy on the phone told me that it was gonna work!
I got that done!
What the fuck was I supposed to do, Julianne? Drive up here and test it myself?
Yeah,
would that have made you happy, princess?
This place has done something to you, Mitch. You've never acted like this before. What's going on?
You know what? I'll tell you what's going on, Julianne. I am your husband now, and you are my wife. I'm not some flunky boyfriend that you could just kick around as you see fit. And if I don't leave, then you don't leave. I'm going to check my traps.
I'm sorry, I yelled at you. I should have never yelled at you like that. It'll never happen again, I promise.
Hey, Jules, wake up. You gotta see this. And there's the craziest bird. He keeps flying around in circles and he just landed on the edge of the island. I've never seen a bird act so crazy.
Have you seen my second case of pills?
What pills, babe?
My, you know, the pill.
No. Should I have?
Tell me honestly, Mitch. Did you take them?
Why would I take your pills? Whoa, baby, take it easy.
Don't tell me what to do!
What the fuck is going on with you lately?
Mitch, we have to leave.
You know what? I thought we already worked that out.
What the hell did we work out, Mitch? That I have to stay here till you say so?
No, we said we'd be here 2 weeks.
And I'm out of pills.
So? What does that mean?
Do you not know what the pill is?
Yes, Julianne, I know what the pill is, but I don't know why you're making such a big deal out of it. What's the worst that's gonna happen?
I could get pregnant, Mitch! What part of this don't you understand?
Well, we're married now, Julianne. We can afford to take chances like that, can't we? I mean, we both said that we wanted to have a family someday.
Someday? Mitch, I said I want to have kids with you someday, not now.
Well, you can't go around planning out every moment of your life. Sometimes things just have to happen.
What is that, a fortune cookie?
No. But if we were following your plans, Julianne, we'd be at home right now, doing the same shit that we do every goddamn day. And if we followed your mother's plans, you'd probably be a veterinarian right now and we wouldn't even be married. But what about my plans? When are we gonna start to follow my plans?
What are you talking about?
Why can't you understand me when I'm talking to you?
I do understand.
You're a very smart girl and I'm speaking very simple English, am I not? Maybe if you stop fucking telling me what to do all the time and actually listened to what I'm saying
Mitch?
To you. You're my wife and I can't even count on you to understand me. How can I trust you to ever listen to me?
Okay, I'm listening.
Good. Because we are not leaving. How was the water?
Thank you.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm just gonna go to bed.
Hey, what do you say you and me, we try some more fishing tomorrow?
Whatever.
Yeah, I can show you my special move. You're a natural, but be careful out there. You're not wearing a life preserver.
I'll be okay.
Back.
This is mine. Where'd you get this? The evergreen? That's where me and Anthony used to go.
I know.
That night we met at the bus stop. You were there. You followed me. You were never even waiting for the bus at all, were you? What did you do after I got off? Catch another bus on the way back? You did, didn't you?
Well, what was I supposed to do? Was I supposed to just walk up to you and say, hey, I've been following you, how about a cocktail?
Yeah. At least it would have been the truth.
You're a pretty girl. Julianne, you stick out in the crowd. It's not a crime to notice you. Sure, I'd seen you there once or twice.
So, Mitch, how long have you been stalking me?
Stalking you? Jesus Christ.
What else you got in there? Mitch, listen to me. It's been 14 days. I'm leaving. Give me the keys.
Look, I'm sorry. I'm very sorry, Julianne. I didn't mean to leave you on the island alone. I know how much you hate to be alone. I needed to blow up some steam, get out of here for a little while.
It's not because you left me alone.
Look, we can work this out. We can.
No.
How can we make a marriage work if we can't make 2 weeks work?
I don't know. I mean, maybe things will get better when we get back.
Why would things get any better? Because you have more excuses to get away from me?
Excuses to get away from me?
Yeah, you're always going out with your friends. I never know where the hell you are.
My friends are not excuses to get away from you. They're my friends.
They're country club snobs, and you know that.
You are so insecure.
You better shut up, Julianne. You better fucking shut up.
What's your problem, Mitch? Are you afraid that I'm just going to walk into some garden party and meet someone smarter than you?
Shut up, Julianne.
He'll certainly be richer than
you.
Better than you?
Julianne!
Don't fucking push me!
You're just a little spoiled brat that's been pampered her whole life, and now you want to run back home to mommy? Huh? You said you wanted to escape all that, Julianne. You said you want to do something different. Well, do it.
I am doing
bullshit! It. You've never done anything on your own in your entire life. You've always had your mother looking over your shoulder. And you know what? You're just like her. Everything is always about you. I'm surprised your real father made it as long as he did.
And yours is any better? Why wasn't he at her wedding, Mitch, huh? Are you just ashamed of me? Or maybe you're just ashamed of him?
Jules, don't you go turning this around on
me. And don't call me Jules.
Why not?
Because Anthony used to, that's why.
Fuck him!
I did. Plenty of times. And he didn't fall asleep afterwards.
You know what? I will fucking kill you.
Mitch, just give me the key.
Don't you fucking ever, ever touch that key.
Julianne, the sun's gonna set soon. Julianne, baby, I'm sorry I got mad at you. And it won't happen again. But you don't want to be out here when the sun goes down, baby. You don't.
There you are.
Thank God you found me.
I'm sorry. Julianne, I'm so sorry.
I'm sorry too. I just got so scared.
I will never lose my temper like that again, I swear. Just don't leave me, okay? Don't run away.
Let's go.
Good morning.
Where's the boat?
What's that, babe?
Where's the boat, Mitch?
Don't know. It must have sank. Don't worry about it, though, Jules. I can still swim.
Any luck, babe?
No, not yet.
Well, if you want to catch anything, you should let me know, all right? Going out for a little while.
Where are you going?
I got stuff I gotta do.
Mitch. Nothing.
Thank you.
to do it?
Don't do anything stupid, Julianne.
Why doesn't the fucking car work? Fix it.
I knew you tried to run, Julianne. You've been acting crazy lately, Jules. Really crazy. I mean, how many times am I gonna have to save you? You wanna drown? Is that what you want, baby? Do you wanna drown? And I'm assuming that you saw the deed to the house. So I'm guessing that you know who that is buried in the woods. Well, you always wanted to meet my father. He's right over there. Where we could be close to him. He loved this place. You would have liked him a lot, Julianne. He looked a lot like me. It was just an accident. You know? I mean, hunting accidents happen all the time. He was always bugging me about finding the right girl and starting a family. He said, Mitch, you're not a real man unless you have a family of your own. I think he would have been real proud of us. And you have no idea how hard it is to make a dead man proud. I was hoping that you would have got to like it here a little bit better before I told you, but since you saw the deed, I guess you know that the house is mine. And since we're married, that means that you have part of it too. Doesn't that make you happy? Isn't that better than living in some house that your stepfather bought for us? We have each other, and we have food, and we have water, and we have shelter, and we have beautiful fucking views. What more could anyone ask for, huh? And you still
Don't try and run away from it. I don't understand you, Julianne. I just need to protect you. I just need to protect you from yourself. Just for a little while until you get better. And you know what, Julianne? This place is a fucking mess. If your mother saw this place... I mean, what the fuck? What the fuck? You would never let your fucking stepfather's place look like this, huh? And you know what, Julianne? You know what? I bet you think that I'm punishing you, don't you? Is that what you think? You think I'm punishing you? I'm not at all. I'm showing you. Julianne, I'm showing you. Look, stuff like this. Look at this. Fucking $12.95 for a tube of paint this fucking big, huh? Why do you need expensive things to make you happy? Julianne. Come here. God, you are so beautiful. Fucking clean this up.
Hi, sweetie. Just making a little dinner. I mean, it's nothing much. Just some leftovers thrown together, you know? Because I couldn't make it to the store today. Oh, I guess I just shouldn't complain. I don't want to be the old ball and chain. Anyway, how about you? How are you doing?
I just want to get a match. Jesus Christ, Julianne. About you, Julianne. I mean, this setup is only temporary, you know that, right? I mean, when you stop trying to jump into the water...
How the fuck will you know when that is, Mitch? I'm chained to a goddamn tree. I can't even go in the water.
I don't know, Julianne, but maybe when you're not in such a bad mood... I know that I hold on to you too tight, Jules. I know I do, and I see myself do it, and I hate it, but I can't stop it. I'm nothing without you. And I didn't want things to be this way, not at all. But they're gonna get better. They are. Really soon, Julianne. I promise.
Today's my mom's birthday. I was supposed to go back for a party, remember? You know, eventually come out here looking for us. And when they do, what are you gonna tell them?
Huh? Does your family know where we are? And not that many people come around this way, Julianne, so I think you should probably just get used to it.
And I bet you knew that, didn't you? You knew that they wouldn't come out here to find us, because they didn't know where we are. I bet you knew that that cell phone wouldn't work too, huh? Did you know I couldn't swim? Did you know that I was scared of the water? Did you Mitch? Because I think you did. I think you knew all those things.
Think whatever you want to think, Julianne.
Just tell me something, Mitch. Has there ever been one thing
failed, Julianne, that was never a lie.
Let me go. Loving me doesn't mean just loving the way I make you feel. My whole life, I've had guys like me for the way I looked. They never understood me. They never even made the effort to find out. Until you. I thought you were different. I thought you were better than them. You think you love me, but you don't. Mitch, please, please let me go, Mitch.
No. No! You walked down that aisle. And you said those words. You said, for richer or for poor, in sickness and in health. You chose those words, Julianne. And when things go bad, you don't just walk away, you stick it out.
But I didn't know that you
What about our it. Family? What about all the kids that you want to have, Julianne? We can raise them right here. I mean, don't you see how much better that is? We can spare them from all the cruel things. But we gotta stop fighting. Because I'm telling you, you don't want to bring a child into this kind of environment. Julianne! Nobody's loved you like I love you.
Go away.